Hi everyone, Mr. E here. Hope you're well, hope you're safe. It's time for another Forest School activity. Today, I thought we'd take things down in size to a micro activity. So in order to do that, I'm gonna need to shrink. Now just bear with me. Oh, there we go. So there are loads of fun things we can do on a micro level in Forest School. One of the things you're going to need for today's activity is you're going to need to find yourselves a little action figure, just like this one. Could be a Lego figure, an action figure, or a doll. Take your figure outside, and why not photograph it doing some of the fun activities we've enjoyed doing together as part of Forest School. This could be lockdown activities, or other activities you've enjoyed doing during school time. Take them outside, show them the activities, and take a photo. Here are some examples for you. I hope you enjoyed that activity and showing your action figures your outside space. Now, for our next activity, I'm going to have to grow back to my normal size. Here we go. The next activity is called Walk a Mile in an Ant's Shoes. You're going to need to measure out 1 meter. Now, you can use a measuring tape like I've done, or you could use a piece of string. It doesn't really matter. And the other thing you might need is a magnifying glass. Now always be careful with magnifying glasses. Never ever point them towards the sky and look at anything in the sky with them. They're used for looking down. And use your magnifying glass to admire the area where the ants live and see things from their point of view. Interesting things you'll find. Our final micro activity is a really, really fun one. It's micro photography. Now to do this, you're going to need a smartphone or an iPad or tablet, something with a forward facing camera, a selfie camera. Okay, now I've got my iPad down here, so we're just going to pan down to that now and I'll show you what to do. You're going to need some water, and very carefully get a little bit of water on the end of your finger and put a tiny little blob of water over the selfie camera. Now if you add to this just to make it slightly bigger, it will help you. So I'm going to do it 4 times to make my bubble nice and large. Okay, and now what you've created is a microscope, and you can take some really, really detailed close-up photos of some things you might find around inside. So I've got a little bowl, a little collection here. I've got a couple of feathers. I've got a couple of rocks, an old snail shell, a couple of different types of leaves. So we'll have a little look at what these look like through my microscope. Now it will look a bit shaky because I've got a wobbly table and the water droplet will move, and you're doing things very, very close up, so every movement is exaggerated. But that's okay. If you take a photo, you'll have a still image. Okay, let's have a go. First of all, with the feather. So I'm gonna hold that now over until it's in focus. And there you go, you can see all the fibres of the feather, and I can take a photo to have a closer look a bit later. I'm going to split open the feather now, see if I can see any of the little hooks on the inside of the feather. Hooks them together, I can, look. Here we go, let's try something like the snail shell. Let's have a look inside the snail shell, can you see that? Ooh, it's got all mud inside it, look. You can see through the snail shell. It's almost translucent look, allowing some of the light through. I'm going to take a photo of that and turn it around. But you can do this with any objects you choose. Let's do one more. Let's do a bit of the, let's do this. A bit of my hedge. I'm really interested to see what this looks like close up. Oh wow, look at those scales. So there we go. How to turn your device into a microscope for our micro adventures this week. I hope you have fun trying the different activities. Stay safe and I'll see you soon. Goodbye.